I'm Detective Christina O'Rear with Grapevine Police Department. I am the peer support and crisis response coordinator. It's so important to help kids understand death. And so I think it's important for us to realize what level they may be on to be able to talk to them about it and to explain. Two and under, they're really not going to understand what's going on. So, you know, whether it's, you know, a close relative, you know, or a friend, you know, a line of duty death, that's one of our brothers and sisters from another agency that we're mourning, they can feel it, and you just need to respond to them with the level of emotion you're showing, because they're going to need that consoling. If it's, you know, your parent, you're going to be a lot more upset, and they're going to feel that. You know, if it's somebody that you kind of just knew a little bit, you may not be as, show as much emotion. So they may not need as much consoling. But under two, they still can sense that. Children 3 to 5, they see death as in a temporary thing, because a lot of times they see it on TV or cartoons or stuff, and somebody gets killed and they come back to life. So they don't have that understanding yet that it's a final thing. They can't understand the abstracts that go along with it. So it doesn't do you any good to explain a whole lot into it, because they're not going to understand. So kids 3 to 5 may feel like the loss of a loved one is a punishment. So I think it's important to let them know that, hey, this is nothing against you. This is not a punishment to you, that this is something that happens. And, you know, later on, we can discuss it more when you get older, that you'll understand more. They may respond with some aggression, use play to kind of escape the reality. And I think that's okay. In fact, if you see a child having difficulty, a lot of therapists use play therapy to help them through grieving and issues. The difference between 3 and 5 and 2 and under is that the 3 to 5s are going to need more of the verbal confirmation that everything's okay. That's not your fault. They're gonna need those hugs also to help them get through the hard times. Between ages of 5 and 10, parents should expect that their kids are just realizing that death is final. And because of that, they get scared. So at this age, they're a little more developed and they're thinking a little more on their own. So they may express themselves either by anger, or they may become really quiet and depressed and secluded. The difficult part on this age group, I think, is that they understand more. They're gonna ask questions and just answer as appropriately as you think that they can respond well to. So from 10 to 18, they're developing a lot more, and they're thinking a lot more on their own, and they're realizing now that death is final. Some people are gonna deal with it with anger issues. Some may feel guilt. Some may seclude themselves. I think it's just important to talk with your child, especially at this age, because you can have a conversation back with them. And again, it depends on their maturity level and what you think that they can respond to. But having those conversations, how are you feeling? Giving them a chance to express themselves, just reassuring them that family's there, their support, and that it's a part of life, and we can get through it together.